You will arise and have mercy upon Zion, for it is time to have mercy upon her. For the Lord shall build up Zion and shall appear in his glory. This is Psalm 101, verses 13 and 16. It's time to have mercy upon her. And this time, determined by God to have mercy upon Zion or upon anyone or upon anything, this time to have mercy is called the time of the divine visitation. The time of the divine visitation. An example for that is the story that you have just heard and you know about it, the story of Zechariah and Elizabeth. They were in old age, and they were all their life praying to have a child, to have a child. And time goes and went on, but there came a time when God visited Zechariah and Elizabeth with his mercy. It is the time of divine visitation to Zechariah and Elizabeth. And the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah. Your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you are to give him the name John." And in Luke 1:24, it says that after those days, his wife Elizabeth conceived. And she hid herself 5 months, saying, "Thus the Lord has dealt with me in the days when he looked upon me to take away my reproach among people." Both Zechariah and Elizabeth could understand and acknowledge that the visit of the angel Gabriel to them, it was a visit from God himself. It was a divine visitation, and it was a sign that it is the time to have mercy on them. And if you listen to the praise of Zechariah after that, when he had John born, he said in Luke 1, verse 68, "Blessed is the Lord, the God of Israel, for he has visited and redeemed his people, has raised up a horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David." So Zechariah could understand that it was a sign of divine visitation, not only to him, but also to the people of Israel, the people of Israel. You might be struggling in your heart with something in your heart, and you pray a lot about it, but time goes on with no answer. But I would like to assure you, there will be a time of divine visitation. Don't let time, it challenges you. You challenge the time because you have the eternal life in you, and time is nothing, cannot challenge the children of God. There will be a time for divine visitation for everyone and for everything, for every wish, for every prayer to be answered. There will be a time of divine visitation. The Bible tells us about many stories about the divine visitations. And the first story ever mentioned in the Bible about the divine visitation is the story of creation itself, the creation. Because the earth was without form and void. The earth was completely destructed and ruined. And then there was a time of divine visitation when God looked about this ruined earth, this void earth, this earth that without form, God looked upon this earth and God said, let there be light. And there was light. And when God said, let there be light, it was a signal that the time has come. It is the time of divine visitation. And then, from that moment, God began to create in 6 days this wonderful creation, this wonderful creation, a time for divine visitation. Another story about the time of divine visitation is similar to the story of Zechariah and Elizabeth. It is the story of Abraham and Sarah. And they lived all their life wishing to have a child. But the time has come. And in Genesis 21, verse 1, it says, the Lord visited Sarah, as he said, and the Lord did for Sarah as he had spoken. And Sarah conceived and bore Abraham a son in his old age at the set time of which God had spoken to him. It is the set time. It is the time determined by God to visit Abraham and Sarah and give them their wish to have a child. Be encouraged. There will be a time of divine visitation for everything you have it in your heart or everything holy you are looking for. Another story about the time of divine visitation is the story of the Exodus of the Israelites from Egypt, from the bondage. They were looking for freedom. They were looking for liberty. They were looking to be in a land to worship God without any hindrance or obstacles. And Joseph prophesied to his brothers, and he said to them, God will surely visit you and bring you out of this land to the land of which he has swore to Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob. So Joseph reminded his brothers that there was a promise. There was a promise from God to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And the time will come, the time would come when God will visit you. And the time really came. And God appeared to Moses, and he said to him, I have surely seen the oppression of my people who are in Egypt, have heard their cry because of their taskmasters. I know their sorrows. I have come down to deliver them out of the hand of the Egyptians and to bring them up from the land to a good and large land, to a land flowing with milk and honey. And from that moment, the story of Exodus, with all the marvelous miracles, began. It was a time when God heard the cry of his people. It was a time when God saw the oppression of his people. It was a time when God expressed his feeling about his people, that he knew very well their sorrows. So if you feel oppressed for any reason, if you feel that you have cries in your heart for any reason, if you feel that you have sorrows and pains in your life for any reason, make sure there will be a time for divine visitation when God will look upon you and God will visit you with his mercy. Another story in the Bible, and I can say that it is the greatest story of divine visitation. It is the story of the incarnation of the Word of God, the Logos. It is the story when the Heavenly Father sent his Son to earth. This was the greatest story ever told about divine visitation. When God sent from heaven his Son, and the Son came from heaven to earth with the name of his Father and with all the power and the authority of his Father, having the Father dwell in him, having the Father doing all the works in him, revealing to us the Father. This incarnation story is the greatest story ever told about the time of divine visitation. St. John said, the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And St. Paul said, when the fullness of the time had come, God sent forth his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive the adoption as son. What a great divine visitation. With the fullness of the time had come. When the fullness of the time had come, there will be a time, a fullness of time for everything in our life. And when God sees this fullness of time arrived, God will visit us with his mercy, with his time of visitation. And St. John said, the life was manifested, and we have seen and bear witness and declare to you that eternal life which was with the Father and was manifested to us. This is the greatest story of the time of divine visitation, when the eternal life which was with the Father appeared to us on earth in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we have seen the Father in him. In the Bible also there is another story about the time of God's visitation. It is how God accepted the Gentiles to be grafted within his people. The book of Acts 15, verse 14. Simon has declared how God at the first visited the Gentiles to take out of them a people of his name. And with these words of the prophets agree, just as it is written, after this I will return, and I will build the tabernacle of David, which has fallen down. I will rebuild its ruins. I will set it up, so the rest of mankind may seek the Lord. Even the Gentiles who are called by my name, says the Lord, who does all these things. And St. Paul quoted from Hosea, in Romans 9:24, he quoted from Hosea 2:23. I will call them my people who were not my people, and her beloved who was not beloved. So there was a time for the Gentiles to be included and to come in to be with the people of God. And I'm sure there will be a time that all the kingdoms will be for God the Father and for his Christ. Jewish will be for the Father and his Christ. Muslims will be for the Father and his Christ. Atheist will be for the Father and his Christ. All the kingdoms, agnostics, will be for the Father and his Christ. There will be a time of divine visitation to every group of people, to everyone. There will be a time of visitation. In our personal life, every one of us may have a story different, that there is a time of visitation. There is a time of visitation in every area in our lives. If we submit and surrender ourselves and our life and our hearts completely to the Heavenly Father, there will be a time for divine visitation, because our Heavenly Father is the shepherd of our souls, our bodies, and our spirits. He said in Ezekiel 34, I myself will search for my sheep and seek them out. And as a shepherd seeks out his flock on the day, he is among his scattered sheep. So will I seek my sheep and deliver them from all the places where they were scattered on a cloudy and dark day. I will feed my flock. I will make them lie down, says the Lord God. I will seek what was lost and bring back what was driven away. Bind up the broken and strengthen what was sick. He is the shepherd. He is the shepherd that he is seeking his flock. He is the shepherd that he gathers his flock. He is the shepherd that he is seeking what is lost and bring back what is driven away and bind the broken as to strengthen what was sick. In Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, I conclude with this wonderful verse, 2 Corinthians 6, 2. In an acceptable time, I have heard you. And on the day of salvation, I have helped you. I tell you, now is the time of God's favor. Now is the day of salvation. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we are your children. We thank you for everything you visited us with the incarnation of your Son, with your shepherding, your pastoral care for us. And here we are submitting ourselves to look at us and bestow your favor and your mercy on us. In Jesus' name, our Lord, glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.